Speaking of like the old school AD carry, if we talked about a little Reckless, Double Lift, Teddy, I feel like you performed better than any of them internationally at MSI. Did you have that feeling before going into MSI that you'd be better? Like, you never played versus like Teddy, Double Lift. You were number one in Europe, but you, like, these are legendary figures in esports and in League of Legends. Like, you felt like, I switched roles, I put practice for about a split, I'm splitting time with Promise Q for my support. You felt like you were going to beat them before the tournament even happened. Like, you weren't scared at all.
I thought if you're playing with Promise Q, I'm going to beat them anyways. I honestly felt very comfortable going to this tournament. Wow. I mean, at some point, I was like inting a bit. So I was like losing a bit of confidence because I was like, I didn't really know why I was doing mistakes that I was doing. Mm-hmm. But before the tournament, I will be confident even if I play with Promise Q on stage, because our scrims in general were like, we were winning lane a lot of games where I would feel just comfortable playing on stage even with him, you know. So I don't really have this like thoughts or my like in my mind that like, oh wow, he's a legendary player or he's a great AD carry, you know, he's main for so long and I'm just not good enough, you know. I think more like, yeah, he's a good player, but I used to play mid, and that's where the shit goes down, you know, in the mid lane, not really in the bot lane. So I felt very comfortable just bringing the mid lane cocky movement down the bot lane.
Do you think other mid laners?
Thing is, though, to be fair, like, it was actually way better in your era, even for mid lane, though. Like, you weren't playing mid lane and then at like level three, knowing like the support and the jungle's just coming in on you if you step forwards. Like, you used to play in the old days where you could just lane.
Yeah, it's true.
It's rough for mid laners now. As soon as that support goes AFK, as soon as they go MIA, you know they're just waiting to come in on you with some mad flash.
Do you think other mid laners would have the same kind of success if they swapped? Or is this something like a unique talent you have? Or do you think mid lane inherently is much more difficult than a complicated role? So if other people swap, they'd be successful too?
Honestly, a lot of questions, good ones. I don't really know how to answer all of them because I didn't really... Okay, first of all, I feel like I don't really know, but in West, I feel like the only player who could do this is like Cups, because I think he has like the skill and the drive to become good enough on the role if he was to roll stuff. Like,
he even said on our show, like, he claimed that when you first asked him to come to G2, he thought that you actually wanted for both of you to take turns at ADC. He said that on the show at least.
Oh, I mean, I don't know about that, right? I always thought the AD because I was like, okay, I don't want to see Cups play AD, you know. But I think he can do it, right? And we were joking a bit, like, yeah. So if you've been both splits, MSI and Worlds, maybe next year I go mid and you go AD. He's like, yeah, let's do that, you know. And now we are halfway there, so maybe next year you never know what happens, right? Mm-hmm. Maybe he wants to play AD and I go back mid, but you have to see first, you know. I don't want to jump to conclusions right now.
He does like challenges. He does say he likes challenges. So
yeah,
I mean, based on his track record and in his career, he would actually do that, like win worlds and then just role swap and then just make life harder for himself. Fair enough.
Yeah, that was actually my plan. Like last year when we like won against RNG, I thought, holy shit, maybe if I just win worlds now, I can just go another role and maybe try again, you know. And
then by the way, since you brought this up, I should probably mention this, because I mentioned this once on a show. I forget which show it was. It might have been the EU one I do. I don't know if I told you this story, Loco, where when G2 beat RNG, because I personally thought RNG was going to win that tournament. Like, I thought they looked like unbeatable.
Oh, I remember this.
Yeah, they made some mistakes. I actually sent, I told this story, Perkz, that I didn't say what I said within it, but I told them that I sent you like a DM, and because I was getting super into it, right? I was like, fuck, if they can actually beat RNG, anything's possible, isn't it, man? And then because I've always told people this, that the one role in the West that will always be as good as Asians is EU mid laner. Like, if you just look in all of history, it's EU fact. Mid. I mean, if anything, Loco, two EU mid laners won the fucking MSI, so we don't even need an EU. I was doubly right. I didn't even know how right I was. But anyway, because I was thinking, well, if their team could beat RNG, IG isn't actually even as good a team. Like, in theory, they weren't at that point. And what's IG's main strength? They're solo laners. Well, who have they got on G2? That's G2's strength. They've got Wonder and Cap. Yeah, so I sent Perkz this message where I gave him like the ultimate like fucking locker room speech. It was like, you know, like, you are an EU mid laner, you know, you can stand against these guys. Like, who gives a fuck if these guys think they're gods, these Koreans? Like, they all still bleed. It's like the most, I went like fully epic, right? And then the joke part is, this is what I told everyone, Perkz, that you did say like, okay, I got this. And then obviously, like, he just got these emotes. It's like, even I was like, yikes. Oh, I don't know if I should have sent that message now.
You were 6 months too early.
Yeah, I mean, yeah, like, we were good, but, you know, they had, like, rookie in the try, so.
Sure, yeah, indeed, yeah. Well, I learned that actually, yeah, it turns out actually some of them are gods, those Korean players. My mistake, rookie, I apologize for thinking you were just a player.